Great test, Elizabeth Short.
What's a sexy girl like you so sad about?
Elizabeth Short was a pale, pie-faced, blue-eyed, dark-haired Irish Protestant girl from the suburbs of Boston, Massachusetts. She was, by all accounts, imaginative, flighty, given to prevarications. She may have been a habitual liar. She was certainly a romantic. She was a tormented, sweet-natured, love-starved, lost little girl who never got the chance to grow up. Her dream was entirely silly, and it was the dream of countless other fatuous girls of the American 1940s. She wanted to be an actress. She wanted to be a movie star. We'll never know if she had talent. Elizabeth Short was last seen on the night of January 9th, 1947, at the Biltmore Hotel downtown. Her body was found Wednesday morning, January 15th. A woman named Bursinger, who was walking her infant child in a baby stroller south on Norton Avenue between Coliseum Street and 39th Street, saw what looked at first glance to be a mannequin off the sidewalk a few inches into the lot. It was Elizabeth Short.
A radio car was dispatched, and what they found was a naked female adult, severed in half, and several detectives as well as the news media responded to the location.
She was nude. She had been bisected at the waist. Bottom half of her body was posed obscenely. Her body bore torture marks, and her mouth was cut ear to ear into a hideous grin.
It was staged. It was almost like somebody displaying a grotesque work of art and saying, look what I've done. You know, isn't this magnificent? And the pictures, you know, make you think, oh my God. You know, it's like, you know, sculpting in flesh. You know, somebody created some horrendous image on a human body. The pictures, once you've seen them, you'll never forget them. And of course, the question's always, when something like that, how does that beautiful girl, which you've seen pinup shots of, become this? And who did that to her and why?
It scared Los Angeles very much. And because she was an actress, it brought that whole community into it. It brought producers into it. It was sort of a seedy story, yet it was sort of a sexy story at the same time because she was attractive. She was a young starlet hoping to make it in Hollywood. And now she is found in a vacant lot, mutilated beyond belief.
Did you read the papers? She's been played up as the hottest number since the atom bomb.
In the 50s and the 40s, it was very sensationalized because we didn't hear so much of this type of violence. So that was front page news for nearly 2 months.
You have to realize that there were only 70 or 80 murders a year at the time in the city of Los Angeles, and probably half that number in the county of Los Angeles. Also, you had 5 daily newspapers in Los Angeles. Circulation wars were in vogue. Radio was very big, and the existing media seized upon this as a huge event and exploited it as such. There is much conjecture as to where she was and who she was with during those 5.5 days. We will never know for sure. It was a huge and exhaustively manned investigation, staffed by many seasoned detectives. They were tripping over each other out in the field. The copious media publicity that this case engendered served to hinder the investigation because many, many leads came in, lunatic leads, people ratting off estranged lovers, people ratting off people who owed them money. It became a circus.
With publicity, you get confessions. With confessions, you get crazies, liars, and false leads. So, we keep some things quiet.
We had a lot of confessing Sams at the time that wanted to admit or say that they had killed the Black Dahlia, but those people were questioned, and because of the evidence we had and the things we knew about the murder, they were eliminated.
I think our friend Bevo means that the examiner
DeBevo's painting Betty in a black dress like some actress in that Alan Ladd movie, Blue Dahlia. She tripled our confessions.
Many theories abound as to why Elizabeth Short became known as the Black Dahlia. Some people say that she habituated a drugstore soda fountain in Long Beach, and that sailors down there near the naval installation saw her. She was always dressed solely in black and dubbed her the Black Dahlia. I don't think that's the case. So other people will tell you that Jack Smith, who is a columnist for the LA Times, dubbed her that. That isn't the case either. Or Bevo Means of the Herald. He called her that. I simply think that someone dropped the tag on her, and it related to the film The Blue Dahlia, which had been released the prior year, 1946, an Alan Ladd, Veronica Lake, William Bendix movie.
Oh, you can smile. I was beginning to wonder.
I was born in March of 48. The crime occurred in January of 47. Here's what happened. When I was 10 years old, in June of 1958, my mother was murdered. It was, in all probability, a date rape scenario that escalated from there. The crime has never been solved. My mother's death corrupted my imagination and engendered in me a tremendous curiosity for all things criminal. I went from being a full-time and big-time reader of general child's fiction to a reader of first children's crime fiction, then adult crime fiction, and my curiosity bloomed to encompass the entire criminal universe. 7 months after my mother's death, on the occasion of my 11th birthday, March of 59, my father got me Jack Webb's book, The Badge. It detailed a lot of racy LAPD cases, and it contained a haunting 10-page summary of the Black Dahlia murder case. I read The Badge, I read the 10-page summary, and Elizabeth Short merged with my mother. She was the symbiotic stand-in for my mother. I used Elizabeth Short to explicate all the emotion that I never felt on the occasion of my mother's death. I took the construction of a single, obscure, and wholly unnoteworthy young woman, her death, and how it ramifies in the lives of scores of people over a sustained period of time. And I spiced it up with outtakes from my past, my love of boxing, my status as a failed light heavyweight, the Zoot Suit Riots, Los Angeles, 1943, my long-standing obsession with the Los Angeles Police Department, my love of LA in the 1940s. I put it all together. The Black Dahlia was that breakout book for me. It was my seventh novel. Bestseller status, wonderful reviews. I went on a book tour and I started meeting Black Dahlia fiends all over the world, people who were obsessed with this murder case.
He creates a whole world, a whole noir world. And the way that the stories are told are very complex. There's nothing simple about it, and very unusual, and A does not follow B, does follow C. And the Black Dahlia, there are like four different stories going on simultaneously. And he has such a unique way of interweaving these different stories and the way things happen and the coincidences. And it makes it uniquely Ellroy.
We have a female Caucasian between 16 and 30. The cadaver is presented in two halves, with bisection level with the umbilicus.
The Black Dahlia case continues to haunt us because we are always searching for the language that elaborates, illuminates the bestiality of this crime. It was baroque, it was wholly horrible. There is no real language to surmount the crime. There is only new language, there's only new psychologizing. I thought in 1987 that I did a good job of explaining the how, the who, and the why. People will come forth from now till the ends of time in their efforts to explain this.
I think it's because of the visual material that the Black Dahlia has lived on for decades and decades, and also it's an unsolved murder. Every year or 2 years or so, there's another person that says, my father or grandfather was the Black Dahlia murderer, and we have a whole bunch of new so-called information or facts that come out that point this way or that way. And it's one of these mysteries that will go on forever, I think mainly because of the very strong visual impression it leaves on you.
All the time I get correspondence from lots of people yearly, indicating that they have their own theories and naming their own suspects. And I got to be honest, I believe it is destined to be forever a mystery. And it's been too long.
I honored my mother when I wrote this book. I honored Elizabeth Short when I wrote this book. I was able to go full circle with the nightmares I had as a child after I first heard of the Black Dahlia case. And they were horrible. I used to be afraid to go to sleep for fear that I would have pictures in my head of Elizabeth Short being tortured. It's a long, long journey. And in some ways, this movie was the culmination of it.